Let's try not to die this time. I've been dying way too damn much. And this time I actually have a little stack of, some diamonds, not a stack of diamonds, but I have some diamonds. Lava's fairly easy to dodge this time around, though. It's kind of obvious where it all is, and doesn't look like I'm going to be digging down too much. No, this is coming. I haven't been this... Wait, have I been this way? Where does this go? I don't remember ever coming down this way, to be perfectly honest. That's so weird. But there's torches here, so obviously, either me or my brother have been down this way before. Trying to just kind of see if any of this looks familiar. This does, but not really. Ugh. Okay, so if I've been this way, I'm gonna go the other way. This way. Cave up there I haven't checked out. Been all up there. Looks like there's a cave further up above that, but I'm not in really a position that I want to try and reach it. Let me see. Need to be careful. I have died so much. Lava has become my friend because of how often I've died. It's absolutely fucking ridiculous. I don't even know if I should go up and try to explore that cave. I don't think my pick's gonna hold out. If there even is anything to explore. Oh, really? Well, looks like it kind of goes up there. There's a hole there. I really need to find my way back. I get so disoriented down in these stupid caves. Can never remember which way I went and which way I haven't. Okay, so this just leads to a dead end. Dead end for now because I don't have the tools to freaking dig my way out. Okay, so I am going to try and make my way back the way I came. I wonder if I could drop down that hole. And just be okay. Also, I guess this goes into a little drop down. Okay, so I came this way. I came from here. So, oh wait. No, it's past the water. I was a dunce and came down here. I didn't make any more pickaxes. Oh, sweet, more diamonds. Really? Awesome, awesome. How many this time? Ooh, it's a vein. Lapis lazuli is always good, too. That's not bad. Not bad at all. I just gotta make my way out of here. And it sucks because I really can't dig my way out right now. Like I said, I don't have the tools. Because me being a dumbass decided to trek down here without looking at my inventory and seeing what I had. 13 diamonds isn't really bad for coming down here. It's just a matter of getting back without dying. Doing some stupid goofy jump or something. By the way, I am playing on peaceful mode. I don't know about you, but I mean, these maps are huge now. I just wanted to explore and get a feel for it before. It's a good little thing I found out that I can add a little message on the bottom of the stream. That way I could put the link to the donation page. I didn't even think I was going to be able to. I was trying to figure that out for the Extra Life charity live stream. Watch the lava. Don't freaking get touched by... Well, I mean, I'm right next to water, so I guess it wouldn't be too bad. Okay, I need to make my way back. I am surprised I didn't find any gold this trip. I would have thought for sure I would have found some gold. Not that I necessarily need it, but always nice to have, you never know. Now, here's the fun thing. I didn't actually go the other way. I went this way first, because it actually opened into another location, so... Probably gonna try out going the other way when I come back down. Because it does look like there might be some goodies kind of packaged down over there. I'm just... How the hell am I gonna get up? Without, like, totally destroying my freaking... fixture there. Should have enough durability to make like a staircase kind of deal. Am I really gonna have to... I'll probably seal that back up eventually. God damn it, go up the freaking ladder. Thank you. Excuse me, I'm sorry. Make another sack of torches. That way that's good. Put that coal away. Two, three, four, five. Go ahead and make another iron pick just to be on the safe side. I think all my crops are ready to go. For what? Which freaking villagers would actually take nether warp? That'd be kind of an interesting thing to add in. I bet in some, like, mods or something, you can get them to take nether warp as, like, a form of trade. Where the hell did that cow come from? That cow wasn't there before. And I don't recall it being up on my crap, so that's kind of weird. The hell did you come from? Cow. Excuse me. You know, I have the space to accommodate. I probably could have. Who dat that's sending me a friend request? Are you in the stream? If you are, say hi. Tiny Miner Girl, that name doesn't ring a bell. Ah, damn it. Crap. I'm usually so good about freaking keeping these things straight. Plant all the carrots. Where they went. Did he appear? Give me one quick sec. I'm gonna pick that up. I'm gonna go see who that friend request was from. Person online? Oh, they are. Sorry about that. Name don't ring a bell, so I'm guessing somebody watching the stream, obviously. Must be. That's odd. I didn't think it actually, like, displayed my username. Well, the only way that she's going to get in, or he... Well, I'm assuming it's a she. I have this match online, but it's set to invite only, so... Unless I send an invite. Unless they ask me. Tiny minor girl. Huh. Still, like, baffling me. That was just, like, out of nowhere. I didn't expect anybody to freaking send me an invite. Oh, damn it. No, I don't want the potatoes up there. That's where the carrots are gonna go. Sugarcane. Netherwort. And make it rain. That's so much more fun than just throwing the whole stack in. Away. Did that iron get done? Oh, it's raining again. Fun. At least, this time I actually have a roof over my head. Cool. Got a good sized stack of iron going. Crazier still, this is only the first map. I haven't even gone and explored. Any direction. I really need to, I've been wanting to make a, building that, shows, like, all the different maps and everything, like, all the different pieces. It's gonna piece the whole world together, have it all mapped out, but I haven't gotten around to that yet. Tiny miner girl. And down the well I go. Hi there. Oh, what's up, man? I didn't know who that was for a minute. I'm sorry. What's up? I had to think about that for a minute. I was like, oh, my nig. That's obviously somebody who knows me. That's freaking funny. That's so weird, dude. Like, on my end, it doesn't say that you're actually in the stream. That's weird. Now it does. Now on my end it says you're in. I had somebody in here earlier, but I have no idea who they were. I think they sent me a friend request. Ooh. God. I didn't think that this actually went that way. How about... No. I don't see any torches, so I obviously haven't been down that way. God, what is up with, like, this map? This map has just, like, generated all these holes. Oh! Oh, cool. Trophy. That means 100 in-game days have passed. Damn, have I really been playing this map that long? Geez. That's intense. Okay, I gotta build myself a staircase, because I don't want to die coming down here. Did I really just hear that thunder? That's insane. Yep, I decided to late night stream because I'm bored. I have to work tomorrow, but it's not till tomorrow evening, so... No, 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 not outside in the game. It's kind of weird. I can actually hear it from down here in this cave. That's kind of strange. I wonder if that leads to the outside then. I mean, that's coming in very, very audible. I want to say that there's a lag in between what I say, what you're seeing, and how I respond to it. But that's Twitch for you. It's always been like that. There's always like a couple second delay or something like that. Even when I go and watch one of my other buddies stream, there's always like a couple second delay between what they say and what they see. More iron, yay! Get all the iron, all the things. Hashtag fuck me. Oh my god. Oh, that is fantastic. God, could you imagine, man, if we could actually get that as like a trending freaking hashtag? No idea. I know, like, he had mentioned something about, I think he got beta keys for some game. And he said whoever he gives the second beta key to, that he wants to stream with that person. I think it's for the Don't Starve multiplayer. The Don't Starve Alone, I think is what he said it was. Other than that, I couldn't really tell you. Oh, I left it. But the... Did it get stuck on the floor? Maybe. It's not letting me pick up that coal. What the crap? Inventory's not full, game. Put that there. Ugh, excuse me. Yeah. Dude, man, you've got me hooked on those freaking chips. I freaking went and bought more. I go through those bags so freaking quick, though, but at least they're only a dollar. I saw gold. Okay, yeah, that's where I did see gold. Cool deal. Okay. We're gonna do this. Without dying. Oh, maybe it's actually... Maybe it's not deep. Maybe it's just one... Dude, did you... I saw that. Freaking, stinking thing caught on fire. Before, baby rage. Success. Made it over the lava, and I think this doesn't go anywhere. Oh my god. Ugh. Of course it doesn't. Thought it went further down, but it don't. Pointless, pointless, pointless. Oh, wait, I see redstone. Still that way, still this way. There went that pickaxe. I know, it's freaking weird as crap that I can hear it. I don't get it. I don't understand it. I'm underground and yet I can freaking hear when thunder strikes. That doesn't make any damn sense. But then again, in this game, what does? I question the logic of video games. Oh my god. Yeah, so it was weird. I was just kind of like starting out the stream, and then I had somebody add me on PlayStation Network. I don't know who the person is. The name didn't ring a bell. I'm assuming maybe somebody saw the link or something. Okay, wait. What's that? I don't know where the crap I'm going. See light. Nope, not smart. Don't mind that one. Mind that one. There we go. Oh, all the coal. I know I close. I'm not 100% sure who else is working tomorrow. I just know I go in from 5 to 9:30, or is it 5 to 10:30? I don't think. Have we started those hours yet? I'm not even sure. I think the schedule said 5 to 9:30. I don't think we start those hours till next week. I know they kept trying to freaking get me to come in. Like, I know Don was texting me, like, freaking out the wahoozle the other day. was trying to get me to come in. And I kept asking him, I was like, did you freaking, you know, email the, or text the holiday hires? Yeah, that's, okay. Okay, so the time does start. But, no, like I was saying, he texted me that he had like 3 hours available or something like that and kept trying to get me to come in. And I kept trying to tell him, you know, hey, you should offer it up to the holiday hires. And I know he said he offered it up to you, but he said that you went to the ER or something like that. And I was like, oh, well, crap. But, you know, I mean, you know, not like any offense, but it's like you're not the only holiday hire. So I don't know. And then I know they tried calling me this morning, but I didn't answer my phone because I was asleep. Because I guess they don't really kind of understand the fact that I'm an insomniac. Saturday. Yeah, that's what he said. I was thinking I got something mixed up with what I was thinking about, but I mean, are you okay, dude? Like, yeah. I think she's on the schedule. I don't know. I'm still not 100% sure if she's even freaking still working with us. I'm right there with you, man. Shit. Oh, I didn't even see that freaking iron there. Well, that's good to hear, man. Like, I was freaking out there. I know, man. Like I said, it'd be freaking hilarious if we could actually get that that hashtag you put earlier as like an actual something trending. That'd be fucking hilarious. Okay, I think for the most part, that's all that's over here, unless I make my way up into that hole up there. I really don't know. I don't know what the crap I'm doing. I'm just freaking mining away, digging holes. Where did I come out of? That's something I didn't even think about. Like, I mean, it's a trend. I think going back this way is the way I actually. Oh. Watch where I'm freaking going. Good Lord, God. Freaking end up killing myself doing something stupid like that. Back up straight into a freaking lava pit. I can already foresee it coming. Whew. Huge coal vein. What's down here? Where does this go? Oh, does that lead like back up to where I was looking at earlier? It leads to nowhere. That's where it leads. There is stuff down here that I can benefit from and take and keep and hopefully not die with. Never have enough coal. When did I... Oh, yeah, I think I went in... I went in Friday? I think it was Friday, because Amanda and Kenan were closing that night. Amanda had bought this, like, big O-ass tin of cookies from frickin' Sam's Club. So she shared, and they were good. Yeah, she said it was, like, $10 for this, like, huge frickin' assortment of cookies. It's crazy. Sam's is ridiculous. Could just buy about just about anything in freaking bulk. That could work. That could work, though. Yeah, I ran over to Walmart as I dropped off my friends for the night and bought me some other bags. Cheap, affordable stack, but the more people buy it, eventually they're going to catch on. Oh, we could start charging more for this. Maybe not. I don't know. I know they had some other brand. I think it was like some like Walmart brand there that it was like some off-brand like Doritos or something like that. Where the hell am I going? Oh. I think it was like 98 cents for that bag, too, and I was almost tempted, but I was like, rather just buy magic. Sometimes it's okay. Sometimes their stuff is okay if it's their store brand. The great value. I actually didn't mind their Pop-Tarts all that much. The great value Pop-Tarts. Because they weren't... I guess they weren't as sweet. I'm not really sure. Can't explain it. Okay, give me one sec. You're still going to be able to hear me, but I'm going to make the screen go dark for a minute. Oh, hi. Yeah, I'm going to check something. Where did that person go? L. It was L, wasn't it? Oh, no, it was T. Okay, I'm back. Check my Facebook. Give me a sec. Let me see. No, that is not where I want to be. Interesting. Let me see. Nice, nice. I'm gonna have to download all those. Yep, man, that's exactly how that would go down. That's fantastic, dude. Yeah, I know you tried to send me that like through the chat, but it was all like wigged out. I don't know why it came out all wigged out on my end. But you're right, that's exactly how we could do that. Yeah, but the only downside to that is that if like someone like Don or someone like one of our managers saw it, they could report it to corporate, and then yeah, things would just get bad from there. That's the only downside. You know, it's as much as I would love nothing more, because I think that would be absolutely hilarious to do. I like my job. I don't want to lose it for doing something stupid on social media because they freaking get all butthurt that I freaking do something stupid on social media. Yeah, that's like I said, that's the only downside to it. Like, you know, if there was a way we could actually get away with it, you know, like, yeah, totally, I'd be totally down. But yeah, I don't think. I mean, Don's checked my Facebook before. I mean, he knew I was, like, super excited when I got hired on, because I guess he saw it on my Facebook. Ow. Oh, so that's where that led. Yeah, only real downside. Other than that, I'd be all for it. Is there iron over there? Okay. Big, giant, effing pit of lava. Not my favorite thing in the world. At least I'm not packing diamonds this time. Unless I find some. Then I will be. But right now, I haven't found any yet. Not on this trip, in any case. Found some on the last trip. Wait, I'm confused. So Peter said something that pissed Don off? And so, like, he went and, like, consulted him in the back about it? That's new news to me. I've never heard about that. If that did go down, I wasn't aware. That's freaking intense. And this happened when he got hired on, or did this happen recently? But you said that, oh, this is when I started, like, 2 months ago. God, I wonder what he frickin' said. I mean, because Don's the kind of guy, like, you know, he just is, like, so... Like, I mean, he's blunt about things, but he's really the kind of guy that, like, is really hard to piss off, I would say. Oh. Okay. We're good. We are good. Crap, I need to get back up that way. I'm just, like, going further down, and, like, I'm not even sure where the crap I'm going anymore. That's why they need to invent, like, some sort of, like, underground map system, so that way I can actually keep track of where the crap I'm going. Not that Minecraft is in any way a bad game, but Terraria has something like that, and it makes things a hell of a lot easier. That just surprises me. Like... And he still kept him on. Again, like I said, you know, to me, Don is just the kind of guy who's really passive on things. Like I said, he's blunt about things, but passive at the same time. You know, and it's kind of weird just to hear that, like, you know, someone was able to freaking set him off like that. That's just weird. There's coal everywhere. I got the space for it, though. Ah! I keep seeing people enter the stream and then leave. I don't know if my numbers are just freaking... Like, my little ticker thing is just freaking out because, I mean, you were in here. And you... It took a while to register that you were actually here. That was... I don't know, but they're, like, coming and going. It's pretty dang fast. It's weird. I know, I'm not the most entertaining person in the world, and all I'm doing is digging holes. But I don't have a second player controller, otherwise I'd have somebody else here, but no one else is like me, and no one else is a night owl like I am. Okay, wait. Wait, where? Okay, no, I went... Okay... Did Pierce say anything saying about me, though? I know he made some, like, offhand comment, but I can't for the life of me, because my memory is just bad like that. No, nothing. He made some stupid comment, and I don't remember what he said. It was something similar. I don't remember verbatim, so don't quote me on this, but I want to say it was something along the lines, like, he was like, yeah, I closed with him, and, you know, I don't know how much longer he's gonna last here, or something. Some stupid offhand comment like that. Something along those lines. And, like, of course, you know, I just shrugged it off, because in my mind I was like, well, it's not really your call. You know, like, he doesn't have the authority to freaking, you know, take someone's job. And, I mean, if it came down to it, you know... You're just back for the holidays, so, I mean, I don't think Don would find that as a reason to, you know, let you go. But, I mean, it's like you had been working there before either me or him got hired on. So it's like, you know, it's not really his call. You know, it really comes up to Don. I'd say don't worry about it. You know, if Don tells you, you know, this is where I weigh things. If Don tells you you're doing a good job, if Drew tells you, or freaking Kenan tells you you're doing a good job, and just keep up the good work, just take it. Because that's what I've just learned to do. I've learned to just tune out anything that freaking Peter says in a negative fashion because it's stupid. You know, like, I'm not going to sit there and freaking be criticized all the time. And, you know, there's always, you know, when it's appropriate, it's fine, but at the time it isn't. It's some stupid off-the-wall comment, like how he was talking about, because, you know, how we're airing the freaking, I was almost going to say VMAs, the Video Game Awards, how we've been airing it, like, segments of it. He made some stupid comment about how, like, he was, like, surprised to hell that Dragon Age Inquisition got Game of the Year because he said it sucked. And I was like, I mean, granted, I was a little surprised by that, too, because of how relatively new it is, but I can't really say. I haven't played the game, so I wouldn't know if it sucks or not. It wasn't on the list of priorities to get, but everybody I've talked to other than him says, you know, it's good. And when a vast majority say it's good, then I'm pretty much like, oh, okay, it's good. But then again, it's all to the eye of the beholder when it comes to, you know, making up your mind about how video games are. I know, dude. I know. Son of a... Where the... I can't remember how I got down here. I will freaking dig all the way out if I need to. Excuse me. Ugh. And like I said, you know, it really comes to the eye of the beholder. You know, I liked the first game, but I never really sat and gave it a good playthrough. Like, I watched my brothers play through it, and then I watched my one brother play through Dragon Age 2 because he was really into the series. Like, he really, really liked the series a lot. And so I watched him play through Dragon Age 2, and then I heard all this stuff about a Dragon Age 3, and then it got changed to Dragon Age Inquisition. I think I actually have the Game Informer that called it Dragon Age 3 at one point. Maybe Dragon Age 3 is a different game or something. Or maybe Dragon Age 3 became Inquisition. I'm freaking so out of the loop on that. But, you know, like I said, it's really not my place to say whether the game sucks, whether it deserved Game of the Year or not. You know, I've only played so many of the new titles of the year because a lot of the titles coming out didn't interest me. You know, there were specific ones. I have yet to play those specific ones. Like Evil Within, Alien Isolation. I did kind of want to give Far Cry 4 a try. When are we? That is that Kenan? Oh, getting an update. Oh, I'm sorry, man. I thought you were a friend of mine. Like, I misunderstood what you were saying. Update. That would be awesome. I know that they just updated it recently for that the Skyrim map and texture pack, and then the Steampunk texture pack. Neither of which I've downloaded yet, just because I'm like short on funds right now. But it'd be nice to see, like, you know, kind of like another update. You know, I was thinking, like I mentioned earlier, I thought it would be cool, you know, like, not because I've played Terraria a lot more before I really got into Minecraft. And one of the things in Terraria that they updated was they added under, like, you can see your map. It's on a 2D plane, of course. You could see the map, and you could see kind of where you're going underground. And I was like, well, that would be kind of cool if they kind of did something like that for this, to where not necessarily maybe like a maybe like some sort of you know, kind of map system where maybe you can actually navigate, because honestly, I get lost so often. I can never remember exactly where I go, you know? Like, I've kind of wanted to develop, like, a system where I place specific torches, like, in oh so many, and that way I can, like, kind of follow the torches. God damn it. I keep freaking falling off that. Oh, there's gold there. But as for, like, any sort of major update, I wouldn't really know, other than I'm not really kind of up to date myself on when the updates come out. I remember the other day I started the game and it was like, oh, update, you know, it was like freaking God, what was it? It was like 118 megabytes. I mean, not too bad, not like a super, super big update, you know, but I was like, big enough to where, like, what the crap are they doing? And then freaking sure enough, the texture packs come out not too long after that, along with the Skyrim add-on. And there went my legs. Didn't need them anyway. Okay, I'm trying to remember, because I know that big old lake of lava down there was kind of one of the reasons I came down here. It's because usually diamonds are kind of close by to lava pits. Let me see. Nope, that's one of the dead ends, I think. That was one of the dead ends. And I'm almost out of pickaxes again. Ugh. I'm gonna have to go back up to the base here soon. If I can find my way back out. Got a good little stack of coal, though. I'm gonna go ahead and throw that in my inventory. I'm almost out of torches, too. Well, I can make more. That's not a problem. Because I actually have sticks in my inventory with me this time. Let me see. Okay. Let me see. Okay. I remember looking down at that and falling through a hole to get down here. If I can find said hole, that would be nice. Or maybe no, I didn't fall through a hole to get down there. I've obviously been down there, but no, okay, yeah, now I remember where this is, what this is. Oh, and I should use the pickaxe that's about to break. Okay, let me see. No, I did not hear about that. That's actually really cool. It was one of those games that I watched one of my brothers play. And I dug it. Like, it wasn't a bad game by any means. I may get that when it comes out on PS4. That'd be pretty cool. I'm like kind of interested. I know one of the other guys in here with us, he told me that he sent me the link. They announced that Final Fantasy X and X-2 are going to be ported. The HD ports are going to be ported to the PS4 in spring of next year. And I'm excited for that because I like Final Fantasy X. That was kind of one of my favorite games growing up as a kid. I know a lot of people don't like it, much like a lot of people don't like Final Fantasy 13 and such, but yeah, like, I'm all for these, like, ports. Like, I mean, it's kind of, like, it's kind of like mixed how I feel about it, because it's like, okay, cool, we're getting ports of like stuff that's already come out, you know, like for next gen. Okay, no, I'm just going back in a circle. It's cool in that regard. Like, I like that concept, like that idea, you know, exposes it to maybe people who missed out on it, you know, of the previous generation. And I mean, that's cool and all, but like, it's kind of like mixed too, because like, I'm like, okay, why can't they make, you know, some more original games, you know, like newer stuff. Like, I know, like, don't get me wrong, like, freaking next year is like going to be insane for freaking for ports, or no, not ports, new games. Like, you know, flipping, we got Dying Light coming out, and in January we've got Final Fantasy Type O. I mean, that's already been out, but we're getting the HD remastered version coming out in March. There's a couple of ports I'm excited for, like Saints Row 4. I'm really excited for that one, because I love the Saints Row games. Those are just so awesome. So it's going to be really fun to play through 4 again. And then Dead or Alive 5 Dead or Alive 5 Last Round is coming to the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One as well. That one I'm excited for as well, because I'm just a big fan of the Dead or Alive games. So that one's going to be pretty cool. Oh, really? No, I didn't hear that at all. That's awesome if they're actually making, like, a new Red Dead. That's really cool. And then that makes sense, then, to, you know, remaster or report the one that, you know, Red Dead Redemption, you know, report that. That makes sense, you know? So I guess that's cool. Like, I'm actually, that's really cool. Okay, so no, that's the stairway I made down here. Okay, I finally remembered where the crap I am. okay, let me see. I just got to get over there. That's the thing. Well, you know what? I'll just drop down here and just make a stairway going up that. Red Dead Redemption 2 confirmed that the sequel is currently in development by Rockstar Games and is stated for release on Xbox One, PS4, Red Dead Redemption. Okay. Oh, cool. Well, that's awesome. Like, I'm actually kind of excited for that. That's legit, though. Like, that's actually really cool that they're actually making another Red Dead. See, okay, I take back what I say. They can make a good, like, get me excited for actual, like, you know, original kind of concept games, you know, because, I mean, no offense to, like, the PS4, I can't say this with, you know, like, not to, like, get into console debates or anything like that, so playing a PS4, you know, Xbox has kind of, like, a one-up on that, because you really do have a little bit more in the way of original titles on the Xbox One. I mean, you've got your share of titles on the PS4 as well, but PS4's kind of been, like, doing a lot of reporting of stuff. Like, I mean, Last of Us got remastered and reported. You know, just like, you know, Final Fantasy X-2 HD was announced as a report. I mean, and then they're porting the Final Fantasy VII, the PC version of the original Final Fantasy VII. Okay, that's... Where are the stairs back up? I know that was, like, a big slap to the face to a lot of people, though, because they were all expecting, oh, it's gonna be the remastered version of Final Fantasy VII that everybody and their mom has been wanting. And I'm all for that, too, if they ever actually did that, but, you know, Square. It's Square. We should just learn to expect these kind of things. Oh, no, like, I'm not saying anything bad about Last of Us, not at all. Like, I know it's, like, one of those, like, pretty much it's, like, one of the definitive games of freaking the PS3 library. So, I'm not, no, nothing bad at all about Last of Us. I just, you know, like I was saying, you know, not showing favor of any particular thing. I'm just saying, like, when it comes to more kind of original titles, Xbox One or Microsoft, in any case, it seemed to kind of at least offer a little bit more in that regard. You know, Sony's kind of resorted to a little bit of just porting stuff, which is fine. Like, I'm all for that because, you know, I mean, especially like I said, you know, with the ports coming out next year, I'm super excited for Saints Row 4 because it's coming with, I mean, the Gat Out of Hell, and not only that, but like, I'm really excited to play on the next gen, so where it's got the higher processors, the better graphics, and runs a little bit smoother, because I played it on the PS3 and I platinumed it, but I noticed that there was kind of like a lot of problems with just like lag, and the game froze on me a few times. I don't know if other people had experiences like that, but what I would really dig now, that would be what would be a really cool port in my opinion. UC4. I'm not familiar with that abbreviation. I'm trying to think of because I heard rumors about Ultra Street Fighter 4 being ported, but I don't know if that's actually legit or not. But getting back to what I'd really want ported, if they ever could, I'm not like expecting this by any means. I would love to see Fallout 3. Maybe do like a package deal, kind of what they did with Metro on the PS4. Package Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas together in like some sort of combo pack that comes with like all the additional DLC and such like that. That'd be really cool. I dig that. Oh, wow. Dead gum. I didn't realize I mined that much coal. Oh, Uncharted 4. Oh, okay. Yeah, sorry. It didn't ring a bell right away. Yeah, I'm looking forward to Uncharted 4 as well. Like, I really need to... I have all the three other games. I really need to sit down one of these days and actually play through them. They've just been kind of sitting up on the shelf. Not that I don't like them. It's just I haven't gotten around to actually playing them. Because, like, I started playing the multiplayer that was free for Uncharted 3, and that's what really got me into it. Like, I was like, oh man, this multiplayer is really fun, and it's awesome that it's free. I wish I had the full game. And then I was like, you know, I'll go get the other games, you know. And so I went and hunted down Uncharted 1, and then I think I bought Uncharted 2 and 3 from my local retro store. I think I got them way cheaper than what they usually sell for. Actually, no, pretty much all of them have dropped in price. I think we're selling them at work for, like, I want to say at least $5 a piece for all three of the games. I think the only one that's, like, slightly higher is the first one, if I remember right. Did you know I have two furnaces? What am I doing? Put that. You know what? I'll make torches. I don't need to do a crafting table for that. I hope so. I don't really have like any like major plans or anything like that. Like, some of my family's coming down. That's pretty much the extent. I mean, I know I work like an insane amount that week. I think I work the 23rd. I work Christmas Eve. I have Christmas off, and then I come in Christmas Day. But I come in the morning and have the evening off, which is good, because I was actually, me and my family, who are going to be in town, are going to go to this concert that night, so I'll be doing that afterward. But yeah, it's just going to be a busy as hell week at work, so kind of looking forward to the hours, but not looking forward to the actual work part. I think that's how most people perceive it, though. It's gonna be intense. Black Friday wasn't bad, just it dragged because I worked the graveyard shift. Not looking forward to that after Christmas rush. Especially now thinking about it that I work at the morning. That's going to be fun. Oh, you know what? Since it's still going, put that in there. How are my crops doing? I know I need to make more sticks. I have to make more pickaxes too. I should pull out cobblestone. I guess I could just move stuff down. I see. Yeah, there's a space. I'll move stuff down. Start. It again. Ugh. Oh, that's probably where I got the seeds last time, huh? I haven't played Warcraft in freaking God knows how long. I was really avidly playing it. If it came to the PS4, I might start playing it again. Probably not, but I was playing it there for a while. Because I do PC game here and there. My PC's not the greatest in the world. I'm gonna get a better one here soon, but I was playing with my brother and a couple of friends. They had gotten back into it, and I was trying to play catch up because I still don't ever. I've never had a character that's reached level 90, mainly just because, like, I have had so much crap with just even starting an account. My first account, when I started playing, and that was way back before, I think the latest expansion was The Wrath of the Lich King, and that's when I had started playing. My first account got hacked, so I pretty much quit after that, and then I came back to it. And just started. I couldn't get back into my old account, so I started a new account, and I started playing it primarily because I think it was around the time my brother had started playing again. But there was a guy who I was quote-unquote friends with. I thought I was friends with. Who had a guild, an established guild. And there was a girl I liked who was playing the game as well. And she was in that guild. And I was trying to... you know, stay in touch with them, touch base with them, playing on Alliance as a Worgen warrior. After that, my brother and his friends got back into playing, and they were on Horde. Always had been Horde, and so I started playing Horde. I started a orc warlock, because originally I was an undead rogue, and I had an undead warrior kind of sitting on some account. It was the same account, but it was sitting on a server that just wasn't doing anything, and no one was playing on that server anymore, so I was like, well, I'll just leave him there, and I'll just start a new character. And so that's my highest level character right now, is I want to say either 49 or 50. I had just gotten up to 50 when I started playing again as an orc warlock, and see, like, all my buddies, you know, my brother and his buddies were all level 90 already, so they were all doing the freaking, you know, instances. They were going through the Mist of Pandaria expansion. I was still way back in, like, the freaking, you know, like, I hadn't even gotten to the point where I was exploring and you know, checking out all the content they added for the Cataclysm and Mist of Pandaria. I started a panda hunter, but I never really played much of it. Like, I don't know. I liked playing a warlock, though. It was fun. Could blast things in the face with destruction magic from, like, a ridiculously far away and keep blasting in the face before. I don't know. I think Blizzard would expand their audience if they went... I think they would expand their audience if they ported it to the console, but the only thing I could see is of them not doing that is just the constant expansions and everything. Like, again, I think it would expand their audience, don't get me wrong. I'm all for people... you know, getting their product out there. That's why I'm really glad that even though Microsoft has the rights and the company of Mojang, that they've left Minecraft alone. And I'm surprised that even, you know, playing the PS4 version that we freaking got updates, you know. Like, I kind of, you know, I thought more or less what Microsoft was going to pretty much do was keep a hold of freaking, you know, the Xbox version and the PC version and, you know, update, give fans whatever they wanted on that, and then they were just pretty much gonna throw, like, they were gonna leave the servers up and everything for, like, the PlayStation versions, but they were just gonna, you know, throw all that to, like, the wind and everything like that with updates. You know, like, I'm kind of glad Microsoft has actually catered to all versions, and they've left, you know, PlayStation's version alone. That they haven't, like, done something, some weird, stupid patch, or try to, like, oh, well, if you, you know, buy our system or whatever, we'll get you exclusive content. They haven't gotten to that part yet. I'm pretty sure that they will somewhere down the line, but they haven't reached that point yet, and I'm kind of glad that they haven't. But I have heard rumors about Minecraft, too, so I don't know. Which is really hard. Like, I've sat there and actually literally tried to figure out how on earth they would make a sequel-ish game or follow-up-ish game to Minecraft. Like, you could just update the base game and just expand it, you know? I with Diablo 3, you know, I mean, that's kind of like, I think in that regard, that's kind of different, you know, like, with Diablo 3, it's more or less, you know, like, I have said that so damn much. Diablo 3, I think the first two Diablos were PC exclusive, if I'm correct. So it was only smart on Blizzard's behalf to make Diablo 3 universal across the board. If they did that with World of Warcraft, like I said, like, I don't think that the PlayStation 4 or the Xbox One are incapable of running it. It's just a matter of Blizzard. I don't know. I guess because Warcraft pretty much has primarily been PC. I know, like, again, like, I'm all for expanding their audiences, and I think they would expand their audience if they did go over to possibly making a console port. I just don't think, because, I mean, you got to remember, although consoles are kind of getting close to basically becoming computers within themselves, their interfaces and everything still require different coding. So they'd have to go and have people code their game, you know, for to work on a console. And I don't think that they would have cross-play servers. Not that I don't think it's incapable of having cross-play servers. I just think that they would probably segregate it in that way. I just don't know. I mean, it's really not something I've really sat and thought about, you know? Like, Blizzard can really pretty much do whatever they want. If they want to port it to freaking console, I'm all for it. But if they don't, I'm not gonna, you know, flip my crap about it. You know, it'd be awesome. Probably give me more of a reason to try and get back into playing Warcraft. But the only thing I could see is that they would be able to let me automatically access all the characters I had already made. I'd probably have to start from scratch, and I really don't want to start from scratch ever again when it comes to Warcraft. Alright, dude, take it easy. Yeah, for sure. If you do, yeah, we'll hit it up then. That I'm not in disagreement with the thought that they would make more money if they expanded. I don't know. It's kind of hit and miss. Like, I've heard, you know, membership has, like, fluctuated so often with their releases of their patches, like the expansions and everything like that. I don't see it happening when it comes to the thought of porting it to console, you know. Like, I think it would kind of almost... I might not be a smart move. I don't know. I don't have any experience in corporations like that, so I couldn't tell you firsthand. I have retail experience. I have nothing. I have no experience when it comes to what developers do and how they go about doing their business. Someday, if I ever actually do get into the industry myself, but until now, as of now, I don't have any say so. Okay. Huh, another friend request. I am a popular person tonight. Sorry, I went dark there for a minute. It's kind of weird. Like, I know that my mic will keep going. But if I exit out to the menu to check anything, it'll go dark. Okay, what do I want to do now? Huh? Huh, another friend request? Huh. That's cool, though. I appreciate the friend requests. I do. Oh, I don't know. Do I want to go back down there? There was a lot of coal and stuff down there. I think I should go and explore. I really do. Like, I don't know what else I... I've just been on a search for diamonds. I don't really know. Apparently, I'm guessing all these people who are adding me have Minecraft. Right now, like, this map is just mine and my brother's, you know. Like, no offense to, like, anybody who's watching the stream. It's no offense to you at all. It's just right now, this map is just mine and my older bros that we're working on. I'd rather not have anybody play with me at the moment. If it's showing down at the bottom, I will be doing a charity live stream on the 21st of December. And Minecraft is on the list of games I hope to play, so if anything, I might start up a new map, and if any of you guys are online, I'd be more than happy to send you an invite. Oh man, I don't know where to go. Maybe I should go down into the place where I was dying all of that time ago. lava is my friend after all the times I freaking died with diamonds in my inventory. Nope. I really need to make this bridge wider. I don't know why I made it so narrow. Or maybe get rid of the pillar thing and maybe just put more fence, maybe? I don't know. It's just a bridge to get from one side to the other so I don't have to constantly swim back and forth. Oh, where is that opening? I know it's somewhere over here. Feels like I've been streaming longer. It's only been an hour and a half. Opening, opening, opening. Ah, there it is. Let me see. Where are some places I haven't gone down here? Wait. I see light. Daylight. Does that actually connect to the outside? Well, obviously, but... I didn't realize that there was an opening so close. Oh, wow. I think this is the first time I've actually seen that opening. Huh. That's actually kind of funny, because that opening I went down, I actually made that opening. I dug my way out because I couldn't find my way back out. Oh, that's hilarious. I didn't realize that there was actually a actual, like, map-generated opening close to where I had actually gone out. Nice big chamber. Let's see. Anything interesting? Or of value? I guess not. Here's a question. Nope. Ooh, more iron. Ow. Ugh. Excuse me. Yeah. And then there were none. According to my ticker, at least. I'll probably stop streaming here in like a half hour or so. I think a 2-hour stream is decent enough. Have to go save the freaking archive file. I'm gonna back out real quick. Oh my god. Wow, the bird. Holy crap. Freaking 4-hour. Oh, man, my bro, I've been all around this place, so I didn't expect to not see torches. I'm lost again, I think. No, wait. No. I think. I am sad. I had an audience there for a little bit. Beggars can't be choosers. Still fun, though. suppose, considering. All things considering, it's freaking... where I live, it's 2:30 in the morning, so... to have people freaking be here was just kind of cool, just all together. I kind of had a constant little steady stream there of people coming in and out. My way. I have no idea where I'm going. Okay, well, that's still the monster spawner. So, not the right way. That's not where I'm going. Find my way freaking back up. I'm gonna find my way out of this cave and I'm gonna end the stream. Coming in for the long call with the charity stream. 12 freaking hours I'm gonna hope to stream. 12 to 11 hours. It's gonna be an endurance. God, I don't have to work the next day. God, that would suck so bad. Oh, boy. Let's not get distracted by the shiny coal. Let's go ahead and find my way out of this damn pit. And yet I'm sitting here getting distracted by iron. Ow. Was and that I didn't know where I was. Oh. Oh, cool. Well, the staircase I made was like right there, so. Okay. Well, I'm gonna make it back to the base and drop off all this crap. And I'll end it. I don't think these things really... When I just do these on the spur of the moment, I don't think they need to go longer than just 2 hours. Especially since I'm only playing Minecraft. Like, I haven't played another game or anything like that, so... I'll try it out maybe tomorrow night or something. I'll try out another game. Try streaming another game, see how it works, see how it goes. I should probably find my way out, up, back this way and just cross the bridge. That's the whole point of why I made it. Yeah, that iron's going. If anybody's still here, thank you for watching. I appreciate it. It's been a fun, good little experience for me. I didn't actually expect people to be in the stream. So, until next time, guys, I'll catch y'all later.